obviously prognostic factors are going to relate to outcomes. The worse the prognosis, the worse the outcome, if you will. But specifically, I'd like to think of it in two buckets. The first bucket is host-related factors. How old the patient is, what the comorbidities are, what other diseases the patient has, whether they've had a prior history of myeloid problems, whether they've had prior therapy, and indeed even whether they have a family history of myeloid malignancies. The second big bucket is the disease-related factors, which pertain to the cytogenetics and the genetics, all of which can be subsumed into overall prognosis. If you just look at the cytogenetics and the genetics, one of the most commonly used prognostic systems is the so-called European Leukemia Net system, which takes into account both features.